So let's now turn to body composition. Now, people might have heard of body mass index, and that is a measure that we take someone's height and weight, and we come up with a number called the body mass index. There's a scale. So if I weigh 160 pounds and I'm 5'7", I'm going to have a certain BMI. If you're heavier, you oftentimes will have a higher BMI. And they used to use the BMI to correlate with if you're overweight or not. And they still do. But we've learned that it's an imperfect measure of body composition. So what this slide is a CAT scan slice of a patient. It's like if you're in a CAT scan, it kind of slices you like bread and takes pictures like slices of bread. And this is one patient, and this is another patient, and they have the exact same body mass index. And what this shows is that their body composition is very different, even though they have the same body mass index. They're both having a body mass index of 29, but in this patient on the right, this person has a lot of muscle. The red in the body is muscle. And you can see that they have quite a bit of muscle. The yellow is visceral fat. And this is fat that's very inflammatory. So the person has some visceral fat, but not near as much as the person over here. And you can see that this person has a lot less red because they have a lot less muscle mass. So even though they both have a BMI of 29, they have very different body composition. They also did some studies that looked at muscle mass and fat mass, and looking at patients with even normal BMIs or even low BMIs can have high fat content and low muscle mass, even if they're not considered overweight. And this is a very bad thing because having low muscle mass is a problem. So in patients who have low muscle mass who get diagnosed with colon cancer, this is a study that showed that about 40% of them had low muscle mass, what we call sarcopenia, at their diagnosis. And they were treated the same as the patients who had normal muscle mass. But what they found is that those patients that had lower muscle mass, the ones with the darker line on the bottom, they had a worse survival from their cancer. And that was independent of their treatment, their stage of their cancer, how advanced it was. If they had bad muscle mass, low muscle mass, they had a worse survival. In this graph at the bottom, the patients that had high body fat and low muscle mass, no matter what their BMI was, they had the very worst survival. So it's not about how you look, and it's not about how much you weigh. It's about how much muscle mass you have. That's actually a really important thing. So this was also shown in breast cancer patients. So in non-metastatic breast cancer patients, so patients that just got diagnosed with breast cancer, they had a CAT scan, they looked at their muscle mass, and they saw that about a third of them had low muscle mass, sarcopenia is the name for that. And they had a worse survival independent of their treatment stage or body mass index. So these two studies, the reason I'm showing them to you is just to show you how important muscle mass is in surviving cancer.